cities, suburban areas, and other places. These places are just as beautiful as these women. Back in the 1800s and 1900s, as well as years before, these places in the United States have been slowly developing into modern areas as we know them today. Many beliefs, like witches and wizards, have been taken out of people's minds. Many people of different places, like Russians, have immigrated into the United States, making the country more diverse. At the same time, many reforms were being made. However, many of the reforms that created most of the life we know today were made during President Theodore Roosevelt's terms. One of these reforms made were concerning of sanitation of food and drugs. Without these reforms, we would not go
yummy yummy in my tummy
when we see food in front of us, and we would not go
out go stomach problems from my behind
when we take in medicine for cure from the illnesses we suffer. Instead, we would probably say,
no, I'm sick. Now I can't go out to watch a movie.
When we eat food that is filled with bacteria, and we would probably say, when we get high from infected medicine. Food and drug protection was not really around in the early times. Many were not aware that some foods can cause problems, such as salmonella, when we eat them without properly made. The most cases where people would go ill would be when they eat meat. Meat packing industries back in those days were more worried about whether they were gaining money from their processed meat. They never were capable or had ever checked for sanity of the meat. Not only would workers in the processing plants not check for contaminated meat, but also would they not check for not healthy animals that were being butchered into delectable meat products. What was more striking was that the government officials were not making any comments about the problems faced from meat. Influenced by these problems that made consumers sick, a muckraking author named Upton Sinclair wrote a book in 1906. This book had trashed the reputation of the meatpacking industry of the United States by stating all the horrors of the industry. The book was so intense, it even made some non-vegetarians into vegetarians. However, it did have some socialist ideas that the readers did not quite approve. This book was wrong track. Anyway, the book was a bestseller in that same year. What was even more better was that Theodore Roosevelt read the book. From this, he was shocked and immediately wanted a law passed to solve the problem faced by the people. Soon in that same year of 1906, the Meat Inspection Act was passed. It only had four strict requirements that the meat packing industry had to follow. They had to have inspections of the livestock before slaughter, have an inspection after the livestock was slaughtered. They also had to make sure that the processing plants were to follow the sanitary standards and were to monitor and inspect the operations of butchering after the livestock was slaughtered. With this passade, people were able to say,
we can eat baked chicken and roast beef.
Amazingly, at the same time, the government wanted to pass another law that would be for some practices for stores and pharmacies to follow for their food and drug items. The government passed the Pure Food and Drug Act of 1906. This act stated that stores and pharmacies are prohibited to sell impure or false labeled foods and drugs, as well as confectionery items containing dangerous substances. At the same time, pharmacies were to put on medicine labels that would indicate the percentages of harmful substances. Without these practices put in place, people would most likely be here. Over the years, the government was paying more attention to the people's health concerning the food they eat and the medicines and drugs they take in. Therefore, after passing the Meat Inspection Act and the Pure Food and Drugs Act of 1906, the government decided to establish a part of the Department of Health of the United States called the Food and Drug Administration, or as we know as FDA. This organization was and is still so nice that they never made us go here every 5 minutes, or even here. Its sole goal is to ensure that we are treated with the proper medications and have food without making us worry about whether it has mad cow's disease or not, since there would not be. Some of the acts passed by the FDA are the Federal Food, Drug, and Cosmetic Act.
Look who's gorgeous.
The Fair Packing and Labeling Act. Prescription Drug User Fee Act. And the Bioterrorism Act. Without these acts made and the FDA, who knows how we would be like.
In the jungle, the mighty jungle, the lion sleeps tonight. In the jungle.